Hello and welcome to TechEd 2020. My name is Dominic Nord and I'm a product manager for SAP HANA Cloud. And today I want to give you some insights into HANA Cloud and how you can start your transition into that. For that, a short agenda. So first of all, I would give you some insights into trends and challenges. So what are these challenges for data management right now? And then how SAP HANA Cloud can support you in live and work with these challenges and to cope with that. So let's start with the data management challenges. You all know that you are in the position that you have your current workload, which is usually a lot of work and you are overloaded with work, but still you need to to bring new use cases, more users, more data into your landscape, into the IT. And with that, you need to optimize the costs with that. So you need to reduce that. You have now the challenges to bring also cloud into your on-premise landscape with all the experiences you already have with on-premise. And of course, it needs to be done right now. So that makes it really, really challenging to do that on top of your already workload. And especially also for employees, that's also a kind of stressful moment and time, because you already have your task you need to do for your current systems, current ecosystem. And with all the new technologies around, you need to skill up with these special requirements. And so here there are many, many tasks around to live in this new world, to give you to integrate all these around in your IT landscape. And so I think that's something we need to support you and help you. And we also have some additional or trends and challenges around the databases in general. We have the huge data explosion. So the collecting of data grows a lot with all the social media and IoT data and so on. And most of it moves actually already into the cloud. And from Gartner, we know, or we got that by 2022, that's not that far away, almost 75% of all databases will be deployed or migrated to a cloud platform. Think that's not something for the next 10 years, right? That's really directly in front of us, and we need to live and succeed with these challenges. And here, that's the point. Everybody expects that you deliver intelligence solutions, flexible, in time, and of course with a low TCO. I think that are some trends and challenges around databases and data management. And with SAP HANA Cloud, we try to support you with that. And most businesses already embrace the data management into the cloud because of these requirements and needs for especially faster provisioning. Nobody wants to wait for weeks and months to get a new instance running, to try something out, or to get a new system for new business needs. Yeah. The same for consumption-based pricing. You only want to pay what you use and not what stays around in your data center, which might be not used for the moment. And that comes together with elastic scale. You want to need your scale, your landscape, together with your business requirements. That's really the important part here. And because of all the tasks, you remember the first slide with all the tasks around your current workload, to have time to support the business, everything needs to be fully managed by someone else. That you have the time to work on the business requirements. And with that, SAP HANA Cloud comes into place. And we want to support you as much as possible to transition from on-premise into the cloud. And we already have some nice capabilities in SAP HANA Cloud to do so. And so the next couple of slides are separated into three different areas. We have the activate part, so what's all in, what are the capabilities to build modern solutions based on SAP HANA Cloud. The second is integrate, so how can you integrate your current landscape, data sources, and so on, and how can this work together, and how can you benefit from the combination of your, let's say, kind of old world and the new world and the cloud. And then, of course, a really, really important topic is trust. You need to deliver a solution where the business can rely on the data they get out of it. First of all, a short look to the architecture of SAP HANA Cloud. And here, the good message is of course the center of SAP HANA Cloud is the SAP HANA engine. So what you know from on-premise, it's all in HANA Cloud. So all the OLTP, OLAP capabilities, graph, spatial, text, and so on. That's all in. But that's the huge advantage also to our previous HANA services we have in place. We complement that a little bit. For example, on the left-hand side, virtualization, really important topic. When you connect remote data sources to SAP HANA Cloud, you have the possibility to not only replicate the data into HANA Cloud, but also to have a federated approach, meaning all the data resides on the remote data source, and you can access that via SAP HANA Cloud and work with that. So have the data modeling and all the execution, the SQL statements on HANA Cloud with data which is on the remote data source. On the other side, we have the persistence layer. And here we did a huge step forward to fulfill the needs or the different needs in terms of storage and storage options. With HANA Cloud, we not only have the in-memory piece for the HANA engine, we also integrated the native storage extension, meaning you have the possibility to also store data on disk. And here the beauty is, especially compared with the dynamic tiering you might already know from the on-premise world, the native storage extension is part of the HANA engine. It's part of the index server. And with that, it's completely integrated. So there is no need to change the application or to tell the application where the data is actually located. So HANA knows where the data is. It's either on disk or in memory. So we have already in HANA a warm and a hot storage option. And then in addition, we have our HANA data lake. And with the HANA data lake, we have the next option. It's a separate service. It's a data lake. It's the possibility to store a huge amount of data in that and even be able to connect S3 or Hadoop or something else to data lake as well to be able to store huge amounts of data. And then, depending on your business needs, move them around in the storage areas. So meaning we have three options, hot, warm, cold, already in SAP HANA Cloud available. And we have the connections to all different data sources. So that's also completely flexible and open to fulfill your needs with regards to your existing data sources. And then on top, we are also really, really flexible on the application side, who can consume or can work together with SAP HANA Cloud. And of course, we have some SAP products like SAP Analytics Cloud or SAP Data Warehouse Cloud, which actually also runs on SAP HANA Cloud. So it uses the database, uses HANA Cloud as persistence. But also third-party applications can be connected to HANA Cloud, or your own custom applications can be connected. So we are really flexible from application, so from consumption side and from the data side. Now look at activate. So what is necessary, what is helpful for the building of modern applications? And here, the huge advantage is, of course, we have everything in one system. So you can reduce the complexity with our multimodal database. with all the geospatial graph documents and more capabilities inside. And of course, it's in memory, so you have all the advantages from the performance side, as you notice from your on-premise HANA, and now combined with cloud-native capabilities like scalability, speed, and flexibility. And last but not least, a simple and flexible pricing, which is also really, really important to fulfill your daily needs in using a cloud service. Let's take a look. Flexibility is a huge topic, especially in the cloud world. And here, let's say we have two dimensions where you can scale, or where you would expect that you can scale. So we have, on the one side, we have the storage scalability. So you want to, or you need to store more and more data. On the other side, we have compute. So you need more compute power to do execution of queries. And here we are not completely done with HANA Cloud. So HANA Cloud is a new product, and we are developing a lot to fulfill your needs. We already done many steps, but we are not finished yet. So that's really also the message that this is our strategic project and we invest heavily in that to fulfill all the needs you have on to work and to live and to succeed with the challenges we already mentioned. So for example, when we look on the storage scalability, here we are quite good. So you can start small and you can scale up with your own instance, so that is possible. Then we have also the storage scale out together with our data lake. So with that, you can scale on the storage level in huge steps. So that's quite good. So here we are quite flexible. On the compute side, we will deliver more capabilities in the near future. So for example, scale out on the higher compute side, meaning you have additional nodes with the focus on compute and not on on the storage level. So that will come, of course. Then what we also have is the classical scale out, as you notice from prem. So this is also something we will deliver. So you can see from the storage side that the focus was to deliver in the beginning more on the storage level, that you can store whatever you have in mind or have in your ecosystem. And next, we will then focusing also on the compute side, because also customer requesting more power on that. And why is that so important, especially in cloud worlds? You all know this chart here, the fixed scaling means that in your current on-premise landscape, you need to size your hardware to fulfill all needs, even if there are only peaks like a Black Friday, a monthly end closing, yearly end closing, all these steps where you need more power, more resources for dedicated small time. The rest of the time, the landscape is kind of oversized because you don't need it. I think that's not acceptable for the future, and nobody can afford the costs to have that. And we see this in discussions with our customers that this needs to be changed, that everybody only scale the system for the current situation. And also here, I think that comes back to the previous slide, especially from the compute side, we are not there yet to be that flexible in terms of having one system which scales up, scales down really, really quick and depending on these needs. But what we already do, And that's also one of the use cases of HANA Cloud, and which many customers coming from the on-premise world really like to start with, is that you have your on-premise world, and this on-premise world is sufficient for the daily work, and but for these peak loads, it might not be. And here you can leverage the capabilities of HANA Cloud, just starting up HANA Cloud in this period of time, having some data there and some queries there, some data modeling there, and then do some execution in the cloud. So meaning you have a hybrid solution with your on-premise world and with some additional power from the cloud using HANA Cloud for that. So that would be a use case which is already working to fulfill that. But of course, our goal is to also deliver a flexible and elastic solution to do that depending on your resource needs in the future. Simple and flexible pricing, also really important, because as I mentioned, we are not completely ready with all the capabilities of HANA Cloud, but we wanted to be ready from the commercialization perspective so that nobody needs to change the contract because we introduce new features or additional features or enhance them also. So that's why we already designed the pricing to fulfill all flexibilities, meaning we have different KPIs for memory, compute, storage, backup storage, and bandwidth. So this is already designed to be as flexible as possible, and as far as we can deliver also this flexibility on the hardware side, this can be already consumed by you. So this is, there's no need to change, and we are using, or you can consume HANA Cloud via CPA. So if you already have a contract with that, you can start using that. And if we have additional functionalities, then this can be used already, no change needed. Next would be integration. And integration is really important topic because you all have your remote data sources in place. And with that, you need to integrate it somehow. And here, the important topics are that we have a seamless connection to SAP and non-SAP with our connectors. We already talked a little bit about the virtual access to reduce copies. That's really important that you have kind of single source of truth for all your data, and nobody wants to have duplicates of the data where you never know what is the current one, or what's difficult to know what's the current one, who changed something where. And with that, the virtual access is a really important topic here. We have the multiple credible storage options. I mentioned that with our in-memory, with the NSE and the data lake, and everything is centrally managed. That's also very important within SAP HANA Cloud. Let's look at that. Data virtualization, important topic. And the good thing is most features or most technologies we are using, you might already know. For the connection types, we use the smart data access or smart data integration. It depends a little bit on the remote data source, what can be used. We try to get as much as possible on the, let's say, easy SDA side, so avoiding the installation of the DP agent. But for some remote data sources, this is still necessary. And what you can see on the picture is we have our Fabric virtual tables. I mean, these are the important topic to do the virtual access and also the replicated access and also the switch between both options. Meaning you can start with the virtual access and then you might realize that because of the amount of data or because of network latencies, that it might not be sufficient. And then you can easily switch from a virtual access to replicated access, meaning the data will be replicated into HANA Cloud and you can work on that. And this is also not a one-time choice. You can always switch back to a virtual access, so that is also easy, easily handled. So no problem. And so with all these options and option to switch between the different options, you can find the right balance between costs and performance. I think that's the point. And you can reduce data duplication and so on with the virtual access. And with that, we also fulfill our, one of the use cases to offer HANA Cloud as the easy access layer to all your data, independent where it comes from. Looking at the data lake, because the data lake is of course not part of, technically not part of the HANA. It's a separate system, but as part of the HANA Cloud provisioning, it will be provisioned together, and also the connection between the HANA engine and the data lake will automatically established and set up. So you can start using the combination of HANA engine and data lake directly after provisioning of HANA Cloud. It's an option, so you do not need to have a data lake if you don't have any need for these huge amount of data storage types. But if you decide to have this later on, it's always possible to also to provision the data lake later on if you start only with the HANA engine. And then of course, when you look at that, so all the blue options are part of HANA Cloud. We have the hot part with the HANA in memory, the warm with SAP HANA native storage extension, and the SAP HANA data lake based on IQ technology. And what I also mentioned is that you can also attach, that's the one in gray, the Hadoop or S3, for example, to data lakes for data ingestion and so on. And then of course, when we go up this pyramid, then the performance will increase heavily. Yeah? So if you go from data lake to HANA in memory, you have a huge performance increase. And here you need to add, or there usually you add more value to data when it goes up the pyramid, because your business will order to do the predictive analysis pretty much based on data, which is in memory, to do decision making analysis. And then of course, on the other side, you can reduce the TCO of the data management, and also increase the volume of the possible storage or possible storages. Yeah, when you go down the pyramid, meaning you can do a kind of data tiering, data aging with our storage options, meaning that. For example, it's just an easy example that you have your current year of data in memory, you have the last year in NSE, and everything which is older in data lake, for example. It's just an easy example. You pretty much have better and other ideas, but just to demonstrate what would be an example for data aging. And of course, with all the capabilities inside HANA, with all the predictive analytics, machine learning, the graph, spatial, and so on, combined with our different storage options and the option to build applications on top using the different the techniques, scripts, languages, and so on. We are really open and flexible to build intelligence application using the combination of storage options and capabilities inside HANA Cloud. And that brings us back also to the activate phase, where we say that everything is integrated. You have one layer with the capabilities of HANA, together with the cloud native advantages and in memory advantages of HANA, to deliver the best solutions as possible. Last but not least, trust. Trust is really important, because with trust, you need to deliver applications or deliver data which the business can rely on. And I think that's always an important topic for SAP. And here, of course, we also invest in security, privacy, anonymization. We have a broad support for SAP, non-SAP, third-party solutions. You can easily adopt it. It's part of the SAP cloud platform, and you can extend your applications using different services from SAP cloud platform. And also here, of course, you have one instance for both the transactional and analytical scenarios. That's really important. Talking about SAP Cloud Platform, just some insights here. Of course, SAP HANA Cloud is part of SAP Cloud Platform, and as a database service, technically we are based on Kubernetes. So as the provisioning infrastructure, we have Kubernetes underneath. It's part of Cloud Foundry, so all application development will be in Cloud Foundry. We are also following the multi-cloud strategy of SAP Cloud Platform. So currently we are running on Microsoft Azure and Amazon Web Services. Alibaba Cloud will follow in Q4 this year, and other hyperscalers in next couple of years or next year. And you can see we have additional highlight services in Cloud Platform, like the data quality management, spatial services, and so on. So many, many more. Web IDE full stack, business application studio, and so on. And all these, of course, can interact and can work together with SAP. Just one additional example of how HANA Cloud and the different capabilities can work together to offer the best built-in solutions is HANA Cloud as geodatabase for GRS partners. So we're working together with S3. And here you can combine the spatial and business data together with machine learning to get the most value out of all the collected data coming from satellites, GPS data, drone data, and so on, IoT data. Everything in one place can be combined to offer the best analytical scenarios. Talking about use cases, I think I touched them a little bit already. One really important use case, acceleration to the cloud. You can extend your on-premise landscape with capabilities of HANA Cloud to start your journey into the cloud. What I explained with customers with on-premise landscape for their basic workload, and then use that for additional functionalities in the cloud for peaks or for new solutions which needs to build up. Start with the cloud and combine on-premise and cloud in a hybrid scenario. Then of course you can have HANA Cloud as your central storage using all our different storage options. And so with the hot in memory, warm native storage extension, and cold with our data lake. The third one, simple access layer to all your data. I think I already mentioned that as well, that you can connect all your data sources, different data sources, current data sources, legacy data sources to HANA Cloud to just have one level, one layer where you can access all the different data from your landscape, from your ecosystem. And there you can decide whether it needs to be federated or replicated to see what fits best into and delivers the best solution for your IT and for then of course for the business. And then of course it's a general purpose database. It's a HANA with all the capabilities I mentioned, OLAP, LOTP, and but that of course is a transactional analytical database, and that's also something you can use it for. Yeah. And so that's more or less from introducing HANA Cloud. We have many, many, many sessions more on HANA Cloud, on administration operations, data tiering options, also extend your on-premise landscape, hybrid solutions, migrating to SAP HANA Cloud, and do performance data science with SAP HANA Cloud. So there are many ticket sessions more on HANA Cloud, and I would encourage you to visit them, to see them as well. to get even more deeper insights into the dedicated topics here. And then, of course, as well, you can continue your learning experience with SAP TechEd this year with the Learning Hub and so on. You can follow different workshops, lectures as well. So this year, everything is virtual. You have even more possibility to follow more sessions than you had with the on-premise TechEd the last years, where you needed to decide what lecture or what workshop you want to follow. This time, you can follow them all. And with that, I would like to thank you for attending the session and wish you a nice TechEd 2020. Thank you very much.
Thank you.